100 students. In this session, we are going to solve our exercise 7.3 of the topic of fraction. In the exercise 7.3, page number 146. So dear students, please open your textbook, page number 146, and on that page number, you can see exercise 7.3. There are the two questions on that page number 146. The first one, write the fractions. Are all these fractions equivalent? So with the help of this diagram, you have to identify that fractions are equivalent or not. Already in the last session, with the help of diagram, how we can recognize the equivalent fraction, already we have studied. So follow that video and try to solve this question in your notebook. Second, write the fractions and pair up the equivalent fractions from each row. So as like that match the following, you have to give the answers of this question. These both questions you have to solve yourself. And if you found any query, you can ask me. So in this session, we are going to solve exercise 7.3 from the question number 3, which are shows on the page number 147. So dear students, without wasting our time, we will start to solve exercise 7.3. And my question number 3 is, replace this box by correct number. That means we have to do here fill the blanks. My first question is, 2 upon 7 is equal to 8 upon box. So in the box, which number I can fill up that my answer will be correct. So 2, in this 2 upon 7, numerator is 2, and in this fraction, the numerator is 8. So we know that in the table of 2, 8 becomes, 8 comes at the 4th place. That means 2 folds are 8. And already in the last session we have studied, whatever mathematical operation if we are doing in the numerator, that same mathematical operation we have to apply in the denominator also. That means the both numerator and denominator, we have to apply same operation, mathematical operation with the same number. So if I multiply this 2 by 4, I get here 8. 2 fours are 8. So as I said, 7 fours are 28. Very good. So here we will write 28. The next question, 5 upon 8 is equal to 10 upon box. So in the numerator, you can see 5 twos are 10. So in the numerator, 8 twos are 16. Very good. The next, 3 upon 5 is equal to box upon 20. So with the help of denominator numbers, I can easily identify. So which mathematical operation I have to apply here and with number. So 5 fours are 20. So same mathematical operation with the same number I have to apply at the numerator. 5 fours are 20. 3 fours are 12. Okay. The next one. This question is little bit different. So look at here carefully. 45 upon 60 is equal to 15 upon box. So I have to convert this bigger number into smaller number. So which operation I have to apply here? Dividation. So but we can think vice versa also. I know that 15 threes are 45. So at which number, to which number if I multiply by 3, I get here 60? Yes, very good. 23 is a 60. So as like that, by thinking vice versa, we can solve like this questions. E 18 upon 24 is equal to box upon 4. So I know that 4, 6 are 24. So which number 6 are 18? Very good. 3 6 are 18. So I will write here. So as like this, we can solve some questions related to the equivalent fraction. Okay. Now the fourth question. Find equivalent fraction of 3 upon 5 having. That means we have to convert this fraction multiplied the denominator. So 5 threes are 50. Okay. So the next is I have to make the denominator 30 of 3 upon 5. So 3 upon 5. I have to make the denominator 30. So how can I do it? 5, 6 are 30. So same mathematical operation I have to use in the numerator also. So 3, 6 are 80. Okay? Numerator. My dear mathematical fraction is 3 upon 5. And I have to convert this fraction with numerator 27. So how can I do it? So if I multiply this 3 by 9, I get here 27. So same mathematical operation I will apply here, 5 times are 45. So as that by using multiplication mathematical operation, I can convert the given fraction into the many fractions which are equivalent to each other. This is about the multiplication. But there are some fractions that we have to convert it into the other equivalent fraction with the help of division process also. So we will look here. Our question number 5 is totally depend on that question. Okay. So question number 5. Find equivalent fraction of 36 upon 48 with numerator 9. Okay. So my real fraction is 36 upon 48. And I have to convert this numerator 36 into the 9. So how can I convert that? Yes, very good. With the help of division process, if I divide this 36 number by, so I know that 9, 4s are 36. So I will divide this by 4. Same number and mathematical operation I have to apply at the denominator place also. So I wrote here 36, instead of that I have to wrote here 48. So 4 8s are, or 9 4s are, which number will come here? Yes, very good. 12 4s are. So 12 4s are 48. So as I get, I can convert the given fraction into the other fraction which is very equivalent to each other. So now I have to make a denominator 4. My real fraction is 36 upon 48. And this denominator I have to convert it into the 4. How can I apply this? 12 4s are 48. Very good. So by dividing by 12, I get here 4. Same operation I will apply at the numerator side. 12 3s are 36. So look at here carefully. When we have to convert the smaller number into the bigger number, we have to apply mathematical operation. And when we are going to convert the bigger number into the smaller number, we have to apply the division process. Okay, so the next question is, check the given fractions are equivalent. So they gave us two fractions. Look at here, the question A, B, C. Already they gave us two fractions. We have to check whether it is equivalent or not. Okay? So we will start to solve this. 5 upon 9 and 30 upon 54. So we will take here the bigger one first of all. Okay? So 30 upon 54. So how can I convert this? Look at here, I am going to do this by Now 6 upon 25, 6 and 25, 1 is odd number, 1 is even number. So both numbers are not comes in a table of any one number. So this is my lowest fraction and the other fraction is 3 upon 10. Look, both are equivalent? No. So these are not equivalent. And now third one, 7 upon 13 and 5 upon 11. So look at here, this 7, 13, 5 and 11. All these four numbers are comes in a table of only itself tables. They are not comes in a table of any other numbers. Okay, so this is a little trick that we have to identify with the help of numbers that it is equivalent or not. So these are not equivalent. Okay, so as I said that we can solve the questions on the equivalent. Okay, so the question number 7 is reduce the following fractions to simplest form. So look at here, 48 upon 60. So this 48 and 60 both numbers are comes in the table of 6. So I will divide this number by 6. 6 8 or in shortcut I can say I know the tables, so I can say these both numbers are comes in a table of 12. So directly I will say, divide these numbers by 12. 12 4 is a 48, 12 5 is a 60. Okay, so try to do like this way in one step. So because for that you have to by heart all the tables. Again, 150 upon 60. So there is a one shortcut. You can cancel as this 0 which are at the same place. Both zeros are at the unit place of both numbers. So directly I can cancel as this number. So I will get here 15 upon 6. And I know that 15 and 6 are comes in a table of 3. So 3 5 is a 15, 3 2 is a 6. Okay? Is it easy? Yes. Very easy. Now 84 upon 98. So just little bit think about the 84 and 98. In which number of table 84 and 98 both numbers are coming? It is little bit very difficult. So we will go step by step. Look at here. 84 and 98. Both this number can be divided by any one number. Yes, both are even. So I can divide this number by 2. So I will do this. 2 4s are 48. 2 2s are 4. 2 4s are 8. And 2 9s are 80. So both these numbers are comes in a table of 7. So I can show directly like this here. So, but I have to do here divideation process. Okay, I am going to log these numbers and solve this afterwards. 7. 7 6 is 42. 7 7 is 49. So this is my simplest form. The next is 12 upon 52. These both numbers are even, so I can divide this number by 2. So 6 2 is 2, 6 is 12. And 26 2 is 52. Again both numbers are even, so I can divide this number by 2. Again 2 3 is 6, 13 2 is 26. This is my simplest form. And the last one is there, I will solve here. Equation is 7 upon 28. So 7 upon 28 both numbers are comes in a table of 4. So 7 both numbers are comes in a table of 7. So 7 plus 7, 7 folds are 28. So as like this, we can solve the questions which are depends upon the equivalent and simplest form. There are two questions, question number 8 and 9. and on that page number you can see question number 8. So we will start to read this question. Ramesh had 20 pencils, Sheetu had 50 pencils and Jamal had 80 pencils. After 4 months, Ramesh used up 10 pencils, Sheetu used up 25 pencils and Jamal used up 40 pencils. What fraction did each use up? Check if each has used up an equal fraction of her, his pencils. So with the help of this question, you can see here on the board I have made here our table. Names, pencils, used, remained, fractions and simplest form. So with the help of these points, now we are going to solve this question. Ramesh had 20 pencils, Sheetu had 50 pencils and Jamal had 80 pencils. After 4 months, Ramesh used 10 pencils, Sheetu used 25 pencils and Jamal used 40 pencils. So how many pencils are remained? To find out the question, we have to do here subtraction. So look at here. So 20 minus 10 remain 10. 50 minus 25 remain here 25. 80 minus 40 remain here 40. Now we have to do here fraction of remaining pencil. Fraction of remain pencils. So 10 remains out of 20. Here 25 remains out of 50 and here 40 remains out of 80. So now we have to find out the simplest form. So we know that 10 ones are 10, 10 ones are 20. So one simplest form is 1 upon 2. 25 ones are 25, 25 twos are 50. So my simplest form is 1 upon 2. 40 ones are 40, 40 twos are 80. So my here simplest form of this is 1 upon 2. So you can see this 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2. All the simplest form are same. So we can say that, look at here what it gives us. Check, each has used an equal fraction. So you can see this, all the simplest form are equal. So each used equal fraction of pencils. Equal fraction of pencil. So for the in the point of view exam, this question is very important. So mark where has I used very important. Okay. So my next last question is, write equivalent fraction and write two more for each. So we have to solve this question as a natural format and we have to write the equivalent fraction also. So look at here, you can see all the numbers having 0 at their unit place. And already we studied that we can cancelize this 0. Okay, so after cancelizing this 0, 25 and 40 remain in the fraction 250 upon 400. So 5 5s are 25, 5 8s are 40. So where you can see 5 upon 8? Here. So I can completely match like this. Okay. And now I have to write the equivalent fraction. So by multiplying 2, by multiplying 3, you can directly write the, you can directly write the equivalent fraction. So 5 3s are 10, 8 2s are 60. Then 5 3s are 50, 8 3s are 24. So to solve this question, I am only using the multiplication by 2 and multiply by 3 to find out the equivalent fraction. Okay. So 180 upon 200, cancel as a 0. 2 9s are 80, 2 10s are 20. So where is that? This one. So equivalent fraction, 9 2s are 80, 10 2s are 20. 9 3s are 27, जा 6, 5 3 जा 50. So as like this we can find out many equivalent fraction of a given fraction by multiplying the given fraction or dividing the given fraction. So this exercise is very important. You have to sum all the 9 sums in your notebook. Okay, and you have to watch this video carefully, listen this video carefully, and try to solve exercise 7.3 in your notebook. Okay.